la 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 we we ba ba we. Lo 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 we we ba ba. La 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 we we ba ba we. Baba we, hello. Lo 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 lo. We we.
Just in case,
Roger. Obiero into in one you agree a dollar way, Baba. Obiero one to one and one you agree a dollar way, Baba.
Okay, you ready for your speech now?
Yeah. And it was, we're 2 days short of 84 years since she was first put in the water in the Yarra River. And she was built. In fact, she had incredible pedigree. She comes from a design from 1935, decided by the St Kilda Yacht Club, then the St Kilda Yacht Club. In 1937, that would become the first of the one-class yachts to come to Port Phillip. So her pedigree comes from her designer, Knut Reimers. As others pronounce Nord Reimers, but it is Knut Reimers. And he, Swedish design, when the St Kilda Yacht Club decided on a one-class, they decided on the Tumlare. The Commodore at the time, Joe White, decided that he would build two of these Tums to get the class going. This is the second YVONNE, YVONNE 97. And there was an YVONNE 94, who became, got another name. Now, she was built by Charlie Peel, pedigree. Joe White, pedigree. Knut Reimers, pedigree. And then she built her own bloody provenance. Because in the between the 50s, mid-50s, right through to the mid-70s, she only ever came nothing worse than second in every race. And it was a sailor by the name of Selim Nurminen, a Finn, or from the islands off Finland, who got stuck on a cargo ship, got lost here and stayed. And he was obviously an outstanding sailor. Well, he won just about everything. So she built her provenance also from the early origins to that, and she therefore became well worth recovering, because in 2003 she was taken, the whole Tum fleet, thank you, diminished in the back end of the 90s, partly of age, partly because they were being pushed out and had to go with other plastic boats and sail with them. So they really, towards the end of the 90s, they died a bit. And Richard Downey, who many of you may know, had three of them just to keep the very Tums alive. But fortunately, the love came from a variety of different sources and they started to be restored. We now have six, this is number seven that we'll be racing, and when the fleet was in its full capacity it was around 14. So having half of them 80 years later is a pretty good effort. So one of the things I really do want to say is that there is an enormous generosity that's come from a broader Tumlaran community, people who've sailed these, and in over 80 years, an awful lot of people get to sail them. But people who come up and tap you on the shoulder and say, I used to sail on that, or I used to sail on something else. Mostly they're bloody Doug's age.
Don't
have to turn his hearing aids up.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Come and turn your hearing aids up.
But there's a wonderful generosity in the community, and absolutely incredible. For example, when we first started the idea, someone who was going to do one, but he said, oh, I've got the nails that I bought bloody 10 years ago, $2,500 worth of bloody copper nail. You want them?
Yeah.
Bloody right we do. So those sorts of the generous gestures has made partly our job easier, but it's just, there's a love, there's a real love. So key things that I want to do, my fellow syndicate members have been amazing. Very special people. Aunt Perry. Matthew. Chris Clapp. Charlie Salter, come and stand forward, Charlie. Come on. And Ferdy Darling, who's the amazing generosity in having us in his shed. It's now 6 years we've been in the shed. Two of which we'd like to say we but it didn't work because of COVID, but it took us 6 years to get this all together. So, again, as I say, without the generosity, without the skills, without the love, this wouldn't happen. Okay.